Hello and welcome to the 30th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this video, I'm going to discuss what we are going to be creating over the next 18 episodes in this third and final section of the course. So now we are getting into the Create a Project section of this course. Over the past 29 videos, I introduced you to After Effects, showcased some handy tips, and we practiced some essential tools and techniques. Now it's time to take all that we have learnt and create a project from scratch. After this section, you should be able to undertake projects alone and create more work comfortably in After Effects. So before we start on the journey into building a video presentation, I just want to go over exactly what we will be creating, so you have a good idea of what's in store ahead. So let's get into it. So here I am in After Effects and I have a project open here. This is what we are going to be creating over the next 18 episodes. So let's take a quick look at this document. Now, if you have the project folder, you can open up this document I have here. With the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, into the folder at the top, Final Document, and open the Final Document After Effects file. And you will have the same document I have open here. Now, if you don't have the project folder and you want to follow along with this video and this entire section where we will be creating this project together, you can download this project folder for a small fee. The download link with the instructions is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, into the folder at the top, Final Document, and open the Final Document After Effects file. And you will see the same document I have opened here. Now, when you open up this document, you may get a few warnings that state a file is missing and a font. Now, if you get this error message, click OK to open the doc, then come up to File and select Close Project. Now, before you open this document, it is strongly advised you first install a font and also download an audio clip that goes with this presentation. The instructions for this can be accessed on the What to Do First page on the free PDF document that comes with this course. So before you go any further, pause this video, open the What to Do First page on the PDF course index, and if you don't have this, it can be downloaded for free. The link is in the description. This will give you the instructions to get the font and the audio file for free, which will enable you to follow along perfectly. So once you have the font installed and the audio file downloaded, we can proceed. Now, before I get into the details of this After Effects file, let's take a look at the finished video presentation that all this is going to amount to. So back into the project folder, click back into the S3 Create a Project folder, into the folder at the top, Final Document, into the Final Export folder, and open the Watch Here document. Now, I have had to upload the end result because it contains audio that I have not been able to provide as part of the downloadable folder. But if you click the link here, this will take you to a video on my YouTube channel where you can preview the final result. So let's now watch the final video together. Beast. So this is what we will be creating together over the next 18 episodes. We are going to create an advert for a travel blog, and the theme will be 5 must-see destinations in London. This is going to include all the key techniques we learned in the previous section, which will put you in good stead to create your own project in future. We are going to be working with video, images, and animating some 2D layers. So let's now jump back into After Effects and take a look at the document that created this video. So when you open the document in After Effects, you will initially find yourself in the main comp. This is a main composition I have managed all the main sections of my video presentation. This video presentation consists of 7 sections, an introduction section, 5 sections in between with video, and an outro section at the end. We also have an audio layer at the bottom, which is the background track for the video. Now, if we look over into the project panel, we can see all the compositions that make up the video on our main comp here, 1 through to 7. And if we look on the top of the timeline panel, we can see the tabs for each section, 1 through to 7. Now, you can either click on these tabs across the top of the timeline panel, or you can double click on the comp layers down in the timeline panel. So if we click on tab 1, we can see the layers that create this section. So all these sections have been created separately in their own composition, and then placed and managed efficiently in the main comp here, which is looking really neat and organized. Now, if you come over to the folder structure, you can see I have organized my project neatly. If you toggle down the assets folder, everything has been organized into 3 key folders: audio, images, and video. And if we click these down, you will see the contents within. So this is what we are going to be creating over the next 18 episodes. I'll be talking in depth about each step in the process and showing you exactly how to do everything. So before you begin, feel free to have a look around the After Effects file to familiarize yourself with the project structure. Once you are happy, we can now embark on the journey to create this project from scratch. Now, creating video presentations like this can be complex and time-consuming. I always find it helps to have a plan before jumping into After Effects, as it gives me something to work to. Once you know or have a rough idea of what you are creating, it's a lot more fun putting it together rather than making it up as you go along. Before I start any project in After Effects, I typically take a little time to plan and design my video presentation. This can often entail planning a timeline guide, sketching storyboards, and designing my video keyframes in Photoshop. In the next video, we are going to start from the very beginning of a project process. In the next video, I'll be discussing the steps I take to plan and design a video presentation from scratch, and offer some tips which I hope will help you. So see you in the next video.